Nimmers and Quan Hampton. Hampton backs up from the goal line. He brings it out to the 15-yard line. A big opening on the left side, out to the 30. He's out to the 40. It's a foot race to the pylon into Redbird territory. A 65-yard return for Quan Hampton to start the game, and it's this top 15 in the conference. And look for Penning and Piney to get back onto the field for UNI as Dom Williams takes it straight ahead. At the bottom of your screen, here is McIlvain on a keeper, and McIlvain's going to take it in from 11 yards out for UNI's first touchdown, an early strike for the Panthers in the first quarter.
Great read.
And there's your secondary, Brown, the freshman All-American, and Sapp, the transfer from Minnesota, as Jefferson on the keeper needs that 35-yard line, gets the 34. And that's going to bring up fourth down as Illinois State keeps the offense on the field in just one passing TD, but two rushing touchdowns now after that opening drive score. Here's the pass out to McShane. McShane makes a man miss and gets taken down at midfield. Take a lot of personnel at every position to get through this season, as here is a catch made on the near sideline. Passing tech. We have not seen Isaiah Weston so far today in uniform, as that is nearly picked off. A great defensive play by Jackson. And as this drive, they keep the Panthers out of the red zone. Cook with the three-point try, and it is good. And now sends Brown out to the right. Looks that way momentarily. Now scrambles. Jefferson flips it and gets it to Tanner Taula for a Redbird first down.
That halfback dive is able to get it.
McCloy, the All-American fullback on the left, he's just going to help Jefferson with the push, and that looks like they got the first down on fourth and short. There's a handoff to Brown straight ahead, and Brown wiggles forward for a first down. Line up front. Jefferson to throw for it again on third down. Escapes the pocket. Looks to throw. Now he's going to run. He needs the 24-yard line, and he'll be 2 yards shy. Junior kicker made a 29 and 25-yarder a week ago. This one is a 43-yard attempt, and it is good. Team-high 7 tackles, you mentioned, Justin. Third down and long. McIlvain back to throw over the middle, out of the hands of McShane. He would have had enough for a UNI first down, but he couldn't hold on.
See if UNI can hold a linebacker back and maybe spy on Jefferson.
Five receivers out for Jefferson. He rolls to his left as he's going to try and run for it and gets shoved out of bounds by the junior linebacker.
Taking a couple of QB hurries.
Now a third and long. There's an interception. Illinois State's Kenton Wilhoit's going to find himself a pitch six of 30 yards. Wilhoit read the play perfectly and takes it in for an
in recognition. Wilhoit going to the flat. McIlvain, kind of a play that normally quarterbacks can do in their sleep. It's always there. One, two steps, bang, get it out of my hand.
Jefferson and company. Looking right side. Looking deep, running out of time. Flips over towards the sideline. Able to stay in bounds. They say yes. What a catch for Tanner Taula.
If it is a catch,
ooh,
awfully close by State.
It's now Brown in the backfield for protection. Jefferson straight back and throws over the middle for Taula. Makes the catch and gets tackled at the 27, 28-yard line as Benny Sapp comes up with a football, who's, as it's ruled down.
A turnover is just, it's extraordinarily big.
This is Hampton in motion. McIlvain is back to throw. Throws for Hampton, and it is incomplete. McIlvain is looking to throw, and he goes down. A sack at the 1 yard line. As it was like a jailhouse break, Michael Gomez.
Do that.
Third down and long for Jefferson and company. Looking over the middle, pressure comes, down he goes. Bronte Wells with the quarterback sack.
Just a huge pressure from Bronte Wells. He's a shutout, which was fitting because defensive coach Farley is.
Something for the trophy case given from athletic director David Harris. That pass completed to Tyson Kirk. This is Hampton in motion. McIlvain to throw. He's got Kershaw again over the middle. He sees him and he makes the catch. Has to go to his knees. So he stops right there at the Illinois State 46. Service alongside Justin Cerency. I am Brad Wells. As the fourth quarter begins with a pass to Quan Hampton out to the right side, enough for a UNI first down on the 13-yard gain. Third down and three, and McIlvain's going to throw. He's looking for Wolf. Wolf inside the five, can't come up with the catch. Woods on the coverage. He threw it up for Logan Wolf, who stands 6'4" and catches.
Yeah, great job giving your receiver a chance to go get the football. Obviously has a chance at it. Good job of trying to jump up and go.
So this is a 43-yard field goal for the lead, and it is straight down Main Street for Matthew Cook. He was the beginning. Third and eight now instead of third and three. Jefferson over the middle. Rutkiewicz, his first catch of the game for a Redbird first down.
Yeah. You see those kind of play action plays.
Jefferson to throw again on third down. Rutkiewicz can't come up with the catch. Falls incomplete, and fourth down is coming up.
For the Panthers.
Illinois State brings pressure again. McIlvain throws, and that one is low. As UNI's offense has an incompletion on third down, and they'll be forced to punt. McIlvain hit as he threw once again.
Creating some noise and making it hard.
Here's Jefferson looking to throw for it, gets tripped up, loses the football. And there's a scrum for the football down at the 24-yard line.
Boy, Jefferson wanted to go deep. He had man-to-man coverage, receiver streaking down the field. Great job on pressure by the Panthers to trip up Jefferson.
Brinkman comes up with it. UNI has the football. Jared Brinkman at the bottom of the pile. McIlvain fakes the handoff. He's going to flip it out to Schnee. Has Schnee for a first down. He needs the 14. He's got the 13-yard line as UNI keeps the drive alive. Waiting for that play clock to get down under 8 seconds. Here's Hoosman left side. Hoosman makes a man miss. Touchdown, Tyler Hoosman. His first catch of the game, and Jefferson gets another one quickly out over the middle, caught by Taula.
This is probably the play of the game.
Here is Jefferson stepping up. He's going to throw it deep, looking for Nagel, and it's incomplete. Coverage by Omar Brown, the sophomore, a preseason all-conference honoree. That is the final play of the football game. Third down, kneel down, no timeouts left for Illinois State as the UNI Panthers, they improve to 2-1 on the season, and 15th ranked Illinois State starts the year 0-2.